I'm honored to invite the Dean of the Faculty of Education, Dr. Ahmed Ejirli, for his welcoming speech, whom we also thank for his endless support in the making of this conference possible.
Dear Vice Master, dear Rector, dear keynote from international abroad, and dear deans, dear visitors and participants from abroad, from around the country, Albania, dear deans and colleagues, welcome to our conference, International Conference on Educational Sciences. This will be the third edition of our conference, and I think this is the more developed edition of the series. I would like to give a short information first about the conference and a short resume about how we proceed. We have 189 participants from 20 countries. From Albania, Algeria, Argentina. I cannot read the others from here, but we have a good diversity in terms of participation. And you will have this resume on our website. Later on, you can have access to the information. We have 137 full paper submissions, and we have 42 poster participations. You can visit them outside. They are presented in the conference coffee break hall. And all the posters will be permanently available at our website, and you can have access to them. And 60 pages out of the contributions are accepted to be published in the Impact Factor Journal, educational journal of and social research journal, and they are permanently available also online. You can have access to them in the website of the journal. And 42 papers published in our BGES journal, which we publish, and we will have the fifth volume of the journal. You can have them as hard copies, and you have them already in your CDs. Which have been distributed to you in your bags. Okay, all papers are published also in our conference proceedings book, all the accepted papers, regardless of the fee variety. And as you have observed this time, maybe I haven't seen an analogy of this type of registration. Maybe there are somewhere. But we tried to make the conference registration as flexible as possible depending on your preferences. Like if you need hard copies, you preferred. If you don't need, you didn't pay for that. That is also another difference of our conference this edition. And all of the posters are available at our website. And the hard copies of the journal have been distributed to the preferred participants, and they are available outside at the moment. You can have them maybe after the session. And now I would like to give the floor to our rector for his welcome speech. Thank you very much for your attention.
There are many problems and challenges continuously in every country of the world. Albania have different problems. European Western countries have some other problems. Third world countries have some other problems. The education has many problems and challenges every time. I would like to thank my dean, the chairman of this conference, and I hope that this conference, the Conference on Education Studies, will contribute to educational sciences not only in local, but in international level. And I wish all of you success to this conference, success to your career, and from all of them coming abroad, enjoy your stay in Tirana. Thank you very much.
Now I'm honored to welcome Professor Dr. Gzim Dibra, Dean of the Faculty of Education at Luiz Guaracuji University in Shkodër, to address his speech.
Honorary Rector of University of Beder, Mr. Jana, Honorary Vice Minister of Education, Mrs. Nora Malay, Honorary Dean of Faculty of Philology and Education in Beder University, Mr. Edili. Dear colleagues, professors and students, it's an honor and pleasure for me to participate in this International Conference of Education Sciences organized today in this so beautiful and comfortable environment. Allow me here to bring greeting of all academics of Faculty of Education at the University of Shkodra and wish you with the best and success in this conference. Faculty of Education at the University of Shkodra has already established a good tradition in teaching and education process. We have a very close collaboration with faculties of education both within and outside the country. We have close cooperation with the Faculty of Social Sciences at the University of Tirana, and we have the close cooperation with other faculties like Faculty of Education in Elbasan, in Duras, Korç, Vlora, and Gjirokastra. This collaboration has created opportunity to improve constantly the entire aspect of our works to target a contemporary teaching and education. Today, I am here as a partner of your school, and our faculty already consider you as important partners in our common goals, improving teaching and education, and facing new challenges that arise with our time in education today. Cooperation means consider you not only as a partner, but also as a new experience for which we need both you and us. This conference is opportunity to discuss and exchange ideas and thoughts in the academic fields and scientific as well. Higher school today is faced with a number of important tasks related to increasing demands for quality education and for a process of qualification, globalization, and information technology. During the university study, we need to realize a lot of activities in order to adapt the skills acquired in school with labor market requirements. I think that all agree that these objectives are achieved if we create a system of internal quality assurance in our university, and if we process and verify the values that we think that we have in such activity as scientific research and conferences. I am confident that we'll greatly benefit from the presentation to be delivered up during this conference, and the ideas and conclusion will be made the object of our works for the future.
Thank you, Professor Dibra. Now I'm honored to welcome Professor Dr. Ksenia Sotirovsky, Dean of the Faculty of Education at Alexander Moisiu University, Duras.
Good morning, Honorable Vice Minister, Honorable Rector, dear colleagues, and my dear students, because I have students also here. We are here today to move further in our mission, improving the quality of education and training, and passing from challenges to opportunities. Improving education is one of the most important investments in our nation that our nation can make. The quality of our education system is determined by the quality of our teachers. To improve our teachers' education, we are here today. We are all together, all the deans and all the staffs of the Faculty of Education. This conference is a good indicator of increasing quality efforts in faculties of education. And Beder University, thank you, Professor Ejeli, is a leader in organizing quality scientific activities in education sciences, and also is a good initiator of common meetings of education faculty staff. Thank you for your investment on the future of our children education. But we have some challenges. We need to spend more time thinking about improving teaching and learning. But we also have to have healthy debates. But we must also find common ground on teaching and learning. We all want the best graduates to become teachers. We all want teachers to be well qualified and to do their job well. We all want a system where poorly performing teachers are supported to improve or required to move out of teaching if they cannot deliver for our children. We all want a system where being qualified to teach is not a one-off event, but where teachers develop their skills, knowledge, and practices over time. We want teaching to be a proud profession, which our best young people aspire to join. We must all tell the world what a wonderful, rewarding job teaching can be. And we want to hear today the conclusions of your research. Thank you and enjoy your scientific day in Beder University.
To welcome Mrs. Nora Malai, Vice Minister of the Ministry of Education and Sports, to address her speech.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you very much for your conference. For me, it's very, very important this conference in the now for the Universitet di Beder. I'm so sorry I'm speaking Albania, but Albania is my country and I am Vice Minister of Education. Thank you very much for my country. To the Nderuar Rektori Universitetit, to Nderuar Dekan të Fakulteteve të Edukimit, to Nderuar Përfaqësues të Universiteteve si motra në të gjithë botën. Është konferencë shumë e rëndësishme sot, ku realizohet në momentet më të rëndësishme të ndryshimeve politike, të qasjeve reale dhe të ndryshimeve që kemi nevojë që të realizojmë të gjithë së bashku. Flitet për sistemin e arsimit dhe sistemin e edukimit. Flitet për rolin e mësuesit dhe dekadave dhe gjeneratave që do të japin vlerë në sistemin tonë. Flitet për universitetet si motra publike dhe private, të cilat tashmë kanë funksionuar dhe fokuson një rol shumë të rëndësishëm, që lidhet me rolin e punëson në përgatitjen e mësuesve të së ardhmes. Sigurisht, të përgatitësh stadin e kërkimit universitar do të thotë që të kesh mundësi të dish si të kërkosh, të dish si të dialogosh, të dish si të hysh në raport e komunikimi, të dish si të vlerësosh punën kërkimore shkencore, të dish si të qosh qasjet dhe të marrësh pozitivitetin dhe të japësh ndryshimin për të kuptuar që në botën globale investimi në sistemin e edukimit është investimi më i rëndësishëm dhe më i qëndrueshëm. Naturisht në emër të Ministrisë së Arsimit dhe Sportit dhe në emrin tim personal, pasi për mua u bën 5 vite në këtë pozicion dhe kam qenë ndër të parat ku i kam thënë mirë se vjen këtij institucioni arsimor, si shumë institucione të tjera, duke menduar që aty ku investohet për sistemin e arsimit, aty është vlera më e madhe investimit të shoqërisë, pasi shoqëria përpunohet, pasi shoqëria zhvillohet, pasi shoqëria vendos dialogun, pasi shoqëria vendos raportin e etikës, pasi shoqëria kupton që të krijosh misionin e të edukuarit, do të thotë të krijosh standardin e procesit të të menduarit dhe pse jo, të procesit të dialoguarit për realizuar pritshmëritë. Më vjen shumë mirë që institucioni i Universitetit Beder ka arritur që në 3 vite të bëj 3 konferenca ndërkombëtare ku qasjen e fokuson në problemet e edukimit të arsimit. Sot jemi në një moment shumë të rëndësishëm ku sapo kemi përgatitur draft propozimin e ri të kurrikulës së re, e cila do të bëhet pjesë e diskutimit të gjithë sistemeve universitare, përpara se ai të përfundohet atje i nevojshëm për sistemin e ri të arsimit 2014-2015. Jemi në qasjen ku për herë të parë vjet kemi kaluar ligjin e ri të sistemit parauniversitar, ku jepet një format tjetër menaxhimit të shkollës, një format tjetër sistemit të edukimit dhe ku kuptojmë që sistemi edukimit është një sistem spiral, ku fillon nga sistemi parashkollor deri në universitet. Dhe nëse këtë spirale e ndërtojmë një qasje të plotë, nëse këtë spirale kemi mundësinë që të operojmë që deri në 2020-ën të japim shanset e një sistemi të qëndrueshëm, ku çdo ndryshim të mos kthehet back në fillimin e shekullit zero, po ku çdo ndryshim të shkojë në vazhdimin e përmirësisë së standardit, natyrisht është suksesi garantuar. Mendoj që në 125 punime që keni ju sot këtu, në përfundimet e diskutimeve dhe referateve tuaja, do dalin modelet për të cilat ne politikë bërësit kemi shumë nevojë. Kemi nevojë të marrim mendimin tuaj, kemi nevojë të marrim kërkimin tuaj shkencor, pasi të kërkosh nuk do thot vetëm të kërkosh dhe ta lësh në një letër, në një paper, po do thot të kërkosh që ta aplikosh në zbatimin e zhvendimit të sistemit të arsimit. Gjithsesi, një falënderim shumë i veçantë për të gjithë ju, që vi jeni pjesë jo vetëm kontributore, por edhe aktore dhe faktore në sistemin e arsimit. Faleminderit dhe suksese konferencës suaj. Thank you very much for all. Thanks.
Now I'm honored to introduce to you the keynote of this conference, Professor Dr. Fred Durbin. Fred Durbin is Professor of Multicultural Education at the University of Helsinki, Finland. He is specialized in language and intercultural education, the sociology of multiculturalism and linguistics for intercultural communication and education. Durbin has published extensively on identity, the intercultural and mobility and migration. He has published over 20 books. Some of them include Politics of Interculturality, Imposters, Interculturals, Linguistics for Intercultural Education. He is series editor of Education Beyond Borders, Peter Lang, and Post-Intercultural Communication and Education. I'm honored to welcome him to deliver his speech.
Let me start with a quote from my favorite philosopher of all. His name is Henry Bergson, and he used to be extremely popular in the 1900s. Now, for some reason, not that many people know him, and I believe that in educational sciences, as much as in other sciences, we should always go back to the past and read and listen to what people had to say in the past, because I think we can learn a lot from what they say. And often, as you notice, we tend to repeat things from the past without even realizing, and it is important to recognize that some of our ideas of today are not actually very new. Now, here's what he said in 1932, and this is how I would like to introduce the idea of interculturality. He said, "We cannot repeat too often that it is not by preaching love of our neighbor that we cannot achieve it." Now, we live in a global world, and we have a lot of what I would say assumptions and misconceptions about the idea of interculturality. Now, I forgot to say that I tend to be quite provocative and maybe a little bit irritating when I talk to an audience. So bear with me, and I would be very delighted if we can discuss some of these ideas. Now, in order to talk a little bit about these assumptions and misconceptions, I will go through three very basic concepts that we seem to be using all over the world without often thinking about what they mean or what they entail when we talk about other people and when we talk about ourselves. These concepts are culture, diversity, and difference. When we talk about Africa, we talk about Africa as if Africa was a country. Do you know what I mean? I heard a very interesting story where somebody was on a plane and they were collecting money for poor people, you know. And so they said, somebody, the air hostess said, she said, "And please remember to give money to our charity through which we are helping poor children in India, China, Africa, and countries like these." Now, Africa became a country, yeah? So it tells a bit about how we see the world also in some other parts of the world. Right, these are some of the books that I've written. My email if you want to send me some comments. And thank you so much for your patience. Hopefully you are not too annoyed by some of my comments, but I'd like to stimulate people if I can. Thank you.
My topic is pupil self-esteem in the early years of education with the different interventions on Tuulaville after the lunch tell more about our research. To start with, just because I could give you a, I don't know how many hours lecture, but unfortunately have 15 minutes. So as I guess everybody of you know that Finland is the top at PISA results. But we have been starting to worry about, because you know we are dropping down, and there's various reasons why we are coming down, and we don't allow it. So we have to do something. So Thulas and my project where we attended was one over how we tried to get pupils' results better. But to start with that, in Finland we have two very important books. The first is National Curriculum for Pre-Primary Education 2010. And the second is National Curriculum for Basic Education 2004. The correlation showed that the sense of security had the biggest connection to any other senses or self-esteem, as I mentioned before. The sense of mission, which is also called the sense of purpose, plays an important role in science learning. And there is a strong connection between the sense of mission and the sense of competence, which again, Griesener sees similar as self-efficacy. I think many of you who are related to psychology, to the self efficacy is very low. The sense of competence seemed to be positive. It was the lowest of all five senses or self-esteem. The results of our study show that the different learning settings can enhance children's self-esteem as seen in the reading interventions. You remember, I saw that those kids had better results. The flexible group was too wide to tell the effectiveness of a certain intervention, and the three-year group was too small to draw any conclusions. So, consequently, more analyses are needed. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Derby, for your presence and also your presentation. Now, at the end of this opening ceremony, I'd like to thank again our faculty for making possible this conference, and secondly, all the participants who honor us with their presence. Now, you are kindly invited for a coffee break at the conference hall.